These Christian missionaries, they are trained. They are trained in giving talks. We hardly know of any Islamic Dawah organization who trains people in public speaking. Today, scientific research tells us that if a person gives a talk on the stage in public, the matter he speaks carries only 7% weightage. Only 7%, 93% is presentation skills. How does he modulate his voice, his eye-to-eye contact, his gestures? The reason I don't have a podium is why? Not that I have a very good physique, is because I want to have my body language, even my body speaking. We in Islamic Research Foundation Bombay, we train professionally Muslims how to convey the message of Islam. We train not only Indians, we even train foreigners. We have got Americans who have come to our organization. We have got Britishers, people from Singapore, from UAE, from Malaysia, from Saudi Arabia. Scholars who have passed from Madinah University. We train them, we specialize in the field of how to convey the message of Islam. How many Muslim organizations we have? Imagine, how can I die? How can I go in the battlefield without my weapon? If the microphone system is not good, how can I fight? This is my weapon. But when Muslim organizations call me throughout the world, they keep me in a five-star hotel, but the sound system is useless. When I accept an invitation, I tell them, the sound system should be good. I will sleep on the floor, no problem. I don't require a five-star hotel. I'm a dai. I can sleep on the floor. But give me a good sound system, it doesn't cost much. But give a professional good sound system. To hire doesn't cost much, it is much less. A small percentage of paying the bill for a five-star hotel. They'll keep me in a five-star hotel, but they don't realize the importance of the sound system. What we Muslims should do, we should train ourselves in the media. To specialize in the field of public speaking is a specialty. Print media is a different specialty. Audio media is a different specialty. Video media is a different specialty. We have to be specialized. And today, we have radio broadcast stations. How many Muslims are doing their job? How many? We have the computer, we have the internet. When the internet started, there was more information against Islam than for Islam on the internet. Now, alhamdulillah, there are some Muslims who have also got into the field. But the Christians are ahead of us. The moment we give a reply, they give the counter reply. On the internet. And the sites are such, I don't want to name them, I don't want to make them popular. The sites are such, you will think it is an Islamic site. You will go to it. It is a snake in your sleeves. The magazine that they print, they have organizations in India, Darul Nijat, Home of Salvation. Arabic name. Who is the president? Sultan. Sultan who? Sultan Paul. Nidai Umid, call for hope. It's a Christian organization. So please don't go on names. Same on the internet you go. I don't want to give the names of this site, otherwise everyone will go and many will get misguided. They give such information which a normal Muslim, even he will not be able to reply. They pick up verses of the Quran and they attack. So as I told you, the media is good as well as bad. It is positive as well as negative. Like a knife, it can be used for good purpose and for wrong purpose. If you cut vegetables and bread, it is good. If you use for robbing, it is bad. Similarly, the media has got advantages and disadvantages. It has got positive points, it has got negative points. It has good things, it has got bad things.